Music, soft melodies that carry us, transport us, and transform us, that which lays bare emotions that words in silence could hardly define. A very happy evening to everyone present here, and welcome to the starry night of musical excellence. The session today is hosted in association with the SPIC McKay North Kerala chapter, and as part of the IIM Kozhikode Knowledge Fest Convergence, brought to you by the students of the postgraduate program in Liberal Studies and Management. We are honored to host India's ace flautist, Pandit Ronu Majumdar, an incredible musician who has popularized the Indian flute among the younger generation. When it comes to flute, Pandit Ronu Majumdar is a style maker and has invented unique style of rendering the raga, which is a good mixture of the Dhrupad Gayaki with Laikari. He is firmly rooted in the Mehar Gharana. Pandit Majumdar composed music for India's very first IMAX film, Mystic India, and has several other accolades to his name, including the Grammy nomination in 1996, the Sangeet Natak Academy Award for 2014, the Lifetime Achievement Award by Navbharat Times, and many others. Films Division of India has produced a documentary film on Pandit Ronu Majumdar called the Bansuriwala. Thank you for joining us this evening, sir. We're also graced with the presence of Ajit Patak, an eminent artist of the tabla. Mr. Patak started his training in tabla at the tender age of 6. He has performed extensively in India and abroad and has been awarded Tall Money from Sur Singer Samsad Mumbai and the HMV Award. Talented and upcoming flute artist Sri Hrishikesh Majumdar is also present in the session today. He has learned music from his father, Pandit Ronu Majumdar, and has also taken vocal training from his mother. He has also worked in the semi-classical genre, having co-composed music for a cover of the Titanic song. We wholeheartedly welcome all of our celebrated artists here with us today. I also extend a warm welcome to our ever-inspiring director, Professor Devashish Chatterjee. May I also extend a warm welcome to Professor Anandakuttan B. Unnithan, Professor Raju C., and Professor Rudra Sen Sharma. I welcome our guiding force and the LSM program chairperson, Professor Deepa Sethi, and all of our other professors. A special mention to Mr. Sitaram Pacham, whose efforts have made this event possible. Lastly, I extend a very warm welcome to everyone on the call today and those watching the show live on YouTube. I will not stand in the way of this celebration of music any longer. May we please start.
Namaskar and welcome you all. I am extremely happy and honored to perform today in a very, very special occasion. IIM Kozhikode is a very prestigious institute in India and globalizing Indian thoughts. IIM Kozhikode is in the silver jubilee year and will be 25 years in 2021. It's a long journey. It is Oxley Ridge campus, a program organized under SPIC McKay, is part of IIM this month-long knowledge fest known as IIM Convergence. Director Professor Devashish Chatterjee is a visionary person with 2 decades of experience in different IIMs. He also taught at Harvard. Professor Deepa Sethi, who is doing this coordinating from many, many years, art, culture programs in IIMs. And I also want to thank my respected C.S. Panchamanna, who is very elderly and, you know, is a blessing to have in the SPIC McKay family. and who coordinated this concert. And I want to thank Pandit Ajit Pathak, who has toured with me in Kerala circuit many times. And one time, my disciple and son, Rishikesh as well. So let's start this wonderful evening Swigmatic concert. And let's start with a wonderful Kalyan Thaat Rag, Rag Bihag. I will present a traditional style, parampara of my Gharana, which is Veenkari. Veenkari explains the Veena. In the olden days, Veenkars were all Rudra Veena players, Rudra Veena exponents. Direct Tamsen's daughter Saraswati was a Veenkar. So I represent that through my hair fragrance, which has given artists like Bharat Ratna Pandit Ravi Shankar Ji, Ustad Swar Samrat Ustad Ali Akbar Khan Sahib, Pandit Nikhil Banerjee, Pandit Vijay Jog, and none other than Pandit Panna Lal Ghosh, the pioneer of Bansuri, who is responsible of introducing this folk pastoral instrument into the classical music. So we all do our pranam. This is his 110th year. Our sincere, humble pranam to Panna Lal Ghosh. Let's start. Rag Bihag.
Thank you. Thank you.
Once again, I want to thank Kozhikode IIM and the whole team, and of course, Panchan Kesanji, our respected Anna, and the whole audience, the students especially, who are responsible of preserving and taking our parampara to the next generation. I'm certainly inspired to play a bhajan, which is not only a bhajan, but a message of humanity. Is Vaishnav Jan to tene kahiye jabhi parai jaane de. The meaning is very touchy and very important. The real Vaishnav is who feels for others' suffering and can help others, is the real Vaishnav. So that is a message from Saint Narasimha Mehta of Gujarat. Raag Kamaj. Thank you. Once again, our sincere thanks from our whole team to the students and watching us presenting our soul through our music. Very soon, I will join all of you for the conversation. Thank you so much.
Such a musical treat. We're really fortunate to have experienced this tonight. Pandaji is on call with us today, but before we move to an introduction, I request Deepa ma'am to say a few words.
Ronu ji, welcome to this program. And we have been mesmerized and the smile has not gone from off our faces right from the moment you began. We are so, so overwhelmed and we are so thankful and full of gratitude that you spent your time with us and took us into the heavenly abode of happiness. Thank you so much. And I open this for interaction. Ronuji.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And I want to thank IIM Kozhikode And it's a silver jubilee moment. It's a very special moment. And to bring the divinity as we believe in Speak Mackay, and I want to thank our respected Panchamanna, so who has been giving us inspiration, you know, very inspiring us, all of us, to, you know, Dr. Kiran Seth and the whole Speak Mackay family for bringing this to IIT, IIM Kozhikode. And we are together, and I'm ready for the instruction. And Ajit Bhai has come specially also to, you know, join us live in interaction. We call question answer session or a little bit interaction.
Yes. Yeah. Please facilitate.
Thank you, sir. Anyone with a question can raise their hands and I can unmute them as we go. Go ahead,
Apurva. Namaste, Pandit ji.
Namaste.
I wanted to ask, how rigorous is your riyaz and how has it become more disciplined over the years?
It has been very rigorous from the childhood when I started, when I was 6 years old. And the discipline, the anusashan is must. For any, not only fine art or bansuri or tabla or anything like that in particular, but I think in every moment or any subject, the basic thing is to be disciplined. Your schedule, your practice. So I used to do like 6 hours, 7 hours, rigorous practice in my childhood. Still I do. And yesterday I did. And so the same with Ajit Bhai, a very rigorous practice.
5, 6 hours.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, go ahead.
Namaskar, Guruji.
Namaskar.
I have a question. When did you realize that this was your calling, and how have you been, when did you realize that you have to pursue this as an all-time profession?
I never realized, or I never decided, or I never planned for it. Very honestly, telling you what has happened to me. I think it was my journey. It was my destiny. I was destined to do this. And I used to be very passionate about the subject. I never thought about the result. I never thought about the success. I never thought about the glamour part of it. I never thought of the popularity, how much people will appreciate. I just wanted to appreciate the music as a practitioner of music, as a worshiper of music, as a student of very sincere disciple of music. And I wanted to do this subject the best of its level. So, and it so happened that I was doing my academic studies along with the bansuri 100%, and I was good at it also. But at, you know, there's a time always decided for you when you cannot balance between two, and then you choose suddenly, and you just think, oh, I think I'm enjoying this more. Let me just do this. Let me just find my own way. Let me just do something that I can survive with my passion. So I think I did that around 1978, 79. I was just 15 years old. And I felt like I cannot do anything else. And let me do this as best of its possible, you know.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
We have a question from Jagriti.
Namaste, Panditji.
Namaste.
I want to know that your perception on what you think would be the present and the future of Indian classical music, and with all the Bollywood music coming up and the indie artists, more of these artists coming up, how do you think that classical music would find its own popularity?
I don't believe that it has to find some popularity. It is already popular. See, I call it massical music. It has to be not classical, but massical. This is a new term I have given. Trilok Gurtu gave me this word. And I really enjoy saying it's massical because it's the basic of every music. The classical, be it Indian classical music or Western classical music. I have the same respect for Mozart as much as I have respect for Tyagaraja Swami or Swami Haridas Ji or anything like that. They're all gurus for us. So classical has to be our background. Any good singer, even from the Bollywood, I have played, as you all must be knowing, I have played many years for Bollywood. I mean, with Ilaiyaraja, Rahman, and you know, father of all of them is Ardi Varman. And I played many years, 30 years with him. So they're all classically trained. Ardi Varman was disciple of Sampa Prasad Ji, Budai Maharaj Ji. And Sarod, he learned from Ali Akbar Khan, sir. So see the, you know, the back. That's why he could compose songs like Bitina Bitai, songs like Yaman Kalyan or something like Bihag, you know, between, it just keeps roaming between Bihag and Yaman Kalyan. Well, so I think it is a popular music. Only one thing Speknake is trying to do is to take this music to the college and school so that these students can be introduced to their own legacy in the childhood itself. So that you should know what you have. There is nothing wrong in appreciating others' culture, but if you forget your own identity, then it's a weird situation. And you realize it more when you go out of the border. When you go to America, I have been teaching in Chicago, Sadhana School of Indian Music from 2003. So it's been, this year, of course, I'm teaching online, taking exams. And well, so cutting into short, first thing they would ask, what is your music? What is you? What do you have to offer from the East? So that's what happened with George Harrison and Bharat Ratna Pandit Ravi Shankar Ji's collaboration. The collaboration, the historical collaboration, which is the collaboration which introduced Indian music to the West. And because of their collaboration, we are globally known. And our recognition is huge. So I think our future of Indian classical music is absolutely great and absolutely safe, and generation next is going to be great. Absolutely.
Thank you,
Pandit.
Thanks, Shreya. Pranam Panditji. The performance was honestly very mesmerizing, and my question was, in what direction do you want to see classical music growing to? How will it shift the paradigm of music industry now?
That's a very good question. I think there will be more collaborations in the coming situations, and because everything is becoming global. I still remember I used to go to Chennai and find very little audience for myself in the early 90s. But then things kept changing, and more of Jugalbandis. And Jugalbandis became very, very popular in last 25 or 30 years. And it started, Jugalbandis of were there in the north, started by, again, Pandit Ravi Shankar Ji and Ali Akbar Khan Sahab, and then Bismillah Khan Sahab and Vilayat Khan Sahab. So also, but I'm talking about the south north, like Lal Guru Jairaman Sir and Ustad Amjad Ali Khan Sahab. And then, of course, the most famous and most, you can say, historical Jugalbandi is Tyagaraja of the last century. Balmurli Krishna was composing I've been very lucky to play many Jugalbandis with him for 20 years or more. So Balmurli Krishna and Pandit Bhimsen Joshi. So these things will bring, the future is more collaborative because the barrier of the language is becoming less and less, and people can share their music because it's all very much online, technological sharing of thoughts and music and ideas and kritis and, you know, endless. So there are going to be more and more collaborative music. That's what I can see. That's my vision. But definitely is going to be classical music.
That's honestly a beautiful vision, sir. Thank you so much.
Namaste, Panditji. Our students are constantly under stress to prioritize studies and work as we go from one phase of our lives to the other. And many of us have lost most of our passions, including classical music and other fine arts. So, sir, I'd like to know what your advice is to our students when we're trying to balance our lives along with our passion as we go forward.
Oh, that's very, I must tell you something. You can't afford to compromise on your passions. A person, a soul, or any individual who compromises on their hobby, on their passion or dreams, is going to be very unhappy, if not today, then tomorrow. So, and that's why I will talk about my father again. He never stopped me doing what I wanted to do. He, of course, gave his ideas, but he never imposed them on me. So I would advise, or I would just humbly suggest, that it's going to help in your studies, as our, you know, late President APJ Abdul Kalam, he always played the veena, you know, Saraswati veena. So, and he was a, you all know that he was a world famous scientist, you know, and how much he did for the world and especially for India. So he was always connected with music. If you are not connected with any creative art, it's you are always going to be thirsty in your in any profession that you are practicing or you are in. But I think very sincerely and very honestly that and practically that your creativity is going to, as you know, Einstein was a violin player, isn't it? So, and he did all this Gurutvakarshan and all this introduced in 100 years back. And any person, and Ramanujan, and, you know, they were classical, they had a classical music background. So it doesn't have to be your profession always. It's your passion. Let the profession decide what is your future. You do your best of effort to fulfill your dreams and fulfill your passion so that you can be a happy soul, and then you can be yourself, a pure, original, God-given identity, because you are born unique.
Lovely to hear that. So thank you so much.
Most welcome.
Oh, Kritika, you can go ahead.
Namaste, Panditji. As you were playing the music, both all three of you, we could see that you were lost. You know, we could see how much you were enjoying the whole session. So it just felt like a very natural extension of you. Are there any life lessons that music specially has taught you all?
First of all, I would like Ajit Bhai, who has especially come live with me and came all the way here on the DG stage, I call nowadays. DG stage is a you know, is a very good term in this period, and we're taking best. So please explain, and you enjoyed the session just now. We finished Rag Bihag, and of course, so if you can talk in the mic.
जब मैं बजाता हूँ तो मैं उनको सुनने की पूरी कोशिश करता हूँ, और जब सुनता हूँ तो खुद इतना आनंद आता है कि बजाने में अपनी एक नई बात पैदा होती है, और एक मतलब म्यूजिकल बजाना होता है, ये सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी, तो सुनना सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी होता है। जब मैं कंप्लीमेंट करता हूँ तो मैं उनको सुनता हूँ, उसको इंजॉय करता हूँ, तो उसके इंजॉय होते हुए मेरे अंदर भी ऐसी ऐसी चीजें पैदा होती है जो पूरी इन्वॉल्वमेंट बनाती है।
I want to say something about Ajit Pathak's musicality, if you allow me. You know, he has toured many circuits with me, including Kerala 2-3 times, and you know, Kerala circuit was very, very memorable every time with Ajit Pathak. Like my younger brother. So his speciality of him, that's why me and Dr. Anrajam, auntie, Amma, I call her, we really love his accompaniment, that soul, where his personality or his ego or anything comes at the last. That would be the last thing he would even think about.
No.
So he would finish. He would just, you know, dilute his personality into the music. So that's the best thing he has. First time I said this publicly with the audience. So, and my disciple and son, of course, he has to go a long way. And he was trying to merge with me. That is what the best thing he should do now. And that's what he did today. And he will do it more and more, because the learning has just begun, and you know, we all are students. We never say that we are accomplished artists. We are music practitioners. We are the bhakta of the
sadhak. Yes.
And it's never ends the journey. It's always a learning experience. You can every day better yourself.
You should be thirsty every time.
Every time you should be thirsty.
Yes, humne sahi aage badha.
Thank you so much. You've left us all happy inside seeing your passion.
Thank you. And I want to give this energy to all of you, because as I said, Yudhishthir always said that the fastest thing to travel is the Man, the Atma. So within a second I can reach you in Kozhikode. I have reached already. I'm there, even with the online conversation. So I think I can give you this urja and this energy to all of you, because I love you all and I respect you all for the kind of efforts that you all are taking to preserve our great ancient art form. So we are going to be great.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Like you said, I think all of us can attest that your soul and your energy has actually reached and touched all of us as well. On behalf of everyone present here, may I extend our gratitude to Panditji, Ajit Pathakji, and Rishikesh Majumdarji for a mesmerizing performance. The music has truly kept us captivated the entire time. I would also like to thank our director, Dr. Debashish Chatterjee, for his presence and his continuous encouragement this evening. I also thank Professor Anandakutan Unnithan, Professor Raju C, and Professor Rudra Sen Sharma for their continued support. Professor Deepa Sethi, the LSM Executive Committee, and the students have been instrumental in bringing this program to fruition. I would take this opportunity to express our heartfelt thanks to all of them. Lastly, I would like to thank everyone present here for their time and for making this event the way it was today a grand success. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. I am Kozhi Panchamanna and the Sethi ji and everyone. Thank you so much.